on the same way they hate, but you say that right there? It's like a
wow, dumb chain effect.
Yeah. World come on, effect. Come on. My God.
But when your back against the wall, could you still say that when you're by yourself? Could you still encourage yourself in the Lord by that?
Yes,
God, if you did that, I know you can do this. If you brought me out when I was praying, now I'm trying to live right. God, look at
God.
Thank you, God.
My God, amen.
Worthy Jesus.
Some things you just don't shout on because it sounds good and popular. You got to become it. You got to become it. You got to take these same words. We got to take these same slogans, same nugget, amen, and put it on the inside. Say, hey, I will not be church alive. I'm going to walk in the power thereof. I don't know what you come to do, but I come to praise his name. I don't know what you come to do, but I come to lift him up. I don't know what you come to do. I come to clap my hands. I don't know what you come to do. I come to stop my feet. You can look at me like it all you want, but when I sing on the goodness of Jesus, ain't got to be in a house of prayer. Come with God, bless my house. Because when you can go to the refrigerator and pull some out of your refrigerator, you can look back over your life. When you really got that on the inside, when I think on the goodness of Jesus and all that he
does,
how could I sit there 2 million times my hands, won't exercise my First Amendment right, and stand up on my feet and say, Lord, I thank you for my feet. They may hurt, but you bless me with them. Thank you for my land. They may hurt, but I thank you for. Thank you for my bank. Oh, it may hurt. See the the devil done told somebody, you ain't got to tap in. But I come to tell you, every time you tap in, God got to give you something. Every time you tap in, something got to unravel for you. The reason why you still stuck, because you ain't tapped in. But if you can realize, then if you praise God with your spirit, if you are saved up to praise, man, I feel ashamed of you.
Thank you.
Go to book of Matthew.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Chapter 4. Here's how you ought to tell that devil. Oh, I thought the apostle was done. See, that's how you got to tell that devil. See, that devil think you done. You ought to give him some more word.
Yes, yes, yes.
You ought to spit the word out.
Yes, yeah. Amen.
You know how you can memorize book, chapter, and verse? Just confess it.
Amen, amen.
Just confess it.
Amen.
Just confess it.
Amen.
Just confess it. Get you one scripture that lock in and know what book, chapter, and verse. Because if the devil ever try to get your mind and get you all messed up, guess what? That book, chapter, and verse is in your spirit. You'll come up out of you like a roaring lion. Y'all ain't saying nothing to let the devil know. Oh, you may have won some war, but you won't win the battle.
God, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Matthew. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. Yes, Jesus.
Book of Matthew. The book of Matthew. Chapter 4. Let me do this here. How many of y'all understand that word?
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, God.
Start with the first verse. Matthew chapter, no, I'm sorry. Go to Luke. Go to Luke. You still in the word?
Thank you, God.
Did I offend you?
My God.
Luke chapter 4.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Matthew, Lord, why keep on Matthew?
Thank you, Jesus.
I say Luke chapter 4, first verse. And Jesus being full of the Holy Ghost. Somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Being full.
Being full.
A message. Jesus being full of messiness. Jesus being full of bitter hatred and strife. Jesus been filled with jealousy. Jesus been filled with partiality. Jesus been full with complaining. Jesus been full with cursing. But just in case my reading ability is not there, what Jesus was full with?
The Holy Ghost.
What Jesus was full with?
The Holy Ghost.
Well, let me say it like this. Congregation, what Jesus was filled with?
The Holy Ghost.
Thank you, God.
Okay, full. He was full. So that means there was no space.
Yeah.
The whole capacity was full.
Thank you, Jesus. That's good.
Okay, see. I'm going to tell you the reason why folks can't get full because they come to church and go looking at everything else, then what paying attention to? Okay, all right. But you want to know why things ain't full. Okay, all right. Jesus, the Holy Ghost, he was full of the Holy Ghost. Full of the Holy Ghost from Jordan. And was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. He was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. So in your wilderness, you need the what?
My God.
In your wilderness experience, you need the what?
The Holy Ghost.
In your time of warfare, you need what?
The Holy Ghost.
Yes. folks say, I want to be like Jesus, but they ain't got the Holy Ghost. Watch this here. Being 40 days tempted of the devil. Being 40 days tempted of the devil, in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. He was tempted of the devil 40 days, right? How in the world you going to go on the fast, you going to eat before the fast over? How in the world you going to break protocol before the fast is over? You just done deleted the whole thing. You fast for your spirit man to increase. Come on one accord by the way of the spirit. Break protocol. You don't break no protocol. You done deleted. If you didn't do the fast, the partial fast, what the instruction, what I said, amen, your fast was in vain. You had anything contrary to what was set in motion before Thursday, it was in vain.
My God.
The devil done defeated you.
Jesus.
So now you wonder why you still in the same place. Why you wondering why you still mad at him?
My God, help Jesus.
Cussing.
My God.
Can't get the mess out.
My God.
God said to help to get the mess out.
Yeah.
But in order for the mess come out, you got to defeat the devil in the mess.
Come on. Amen.
Oh, I ain't going to help. Let me convey fasting like this. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Help me, Lord. We must have nutrients, protein,
amen,
all that good stuff. So, you know, our belly could be our God too.
Mm, you preaching? For real.
Our belly could be our God. Glutton could be our God. Mm-hmm. But when you sustain from eating, you making the flesh come upon a suggestion.
Yes. Amen, amen.
And you rely on the Spirit of God to lead you.
Yes.
I wish I could get some help right now. And so why your body is not getting what it's craving? Oh, you wrestling now. Your mind wrestling now. Your stomach's a...